Hey everybody, as it's such a lovely October day, I thought I'll take you out for a walk again. And I thought we'd start at the Herrenhuter Gardens, which is a lovely park in Hanover, where you can run around, which I usually do. And you can also go inside in the summer, and then you can see fountains and statues and lovely garden arrangements. But of course I didn't only want to show you the gardens, I also wanted to tell you about A Million Suns by Beth Rivers finally. This is a sequel to Across the Universe, so if you haven't read Across the Universe, this video will spoil that book for you. So don't watch it. So where does the story continue? It's been 3 months since Eldest died, and 3 months since Orion has been frozen, and also 3 months without Phytus, the drug that kept the population of Godspeed compliant. For 3 months now, Elder has been doing his best to lead his people and fix the engine, but not everything works well. He learned that the engine isn't broken, but actually that the ship has stopped. And the people are not as supportive as he expected them to be. Some have stopped working, others got depressed, and overall, more and more people doubt his leadership. Godspeed is in a severe state of chaos and on the verge of a rebellion. There you can see one of the fountains. For Amy, these past 3 months meant that she has learned how to hide from the people of Godspeed, who is still wary of her. She's still not part of the ship, and she doesn't want to be. It is not until she finds a message from Orion that she gets active again. He left her like little clues for a treasure hunt to seek a big secret, and he trusts her to make the right decision. That is mainly the story, chaos and a mystery to solve. Just as in Across the Universe, the writing is slow and very detailed, and at some passages it's unbearably repetitious. Action scenes are few and short, or rather fast compared to the rest of the story. It's rather sad. Looking at the characters, Edda grows stronger and more confident. Yes, he's still insecure and stupid sometimes, but he's still likable. Amy, on the other hand, gets more and more annoying. She is fighting against everything. And she basically still doesn't want to be on the ship. Everything she sees is just how it's not Earth. Understandably, she struggles with trust issues ever since Elder confessed on freezing her. But the most annoying thing for me was that she kept doubting her feelings for Elder. She kept saying she wanted to have a choice and wondered if she'd be in love with him, if she had a choice, if she were on Earth, and if he wasn't the only person who liked her. And that was rather annoying and repetitious. In Across the Universe, a huge part of the story was the oppressiveness of the system. And since Eldest is dead, Elder has taken over control, and he's sort of clinging to the system, but he's opening it up. He's introducing police forces and other things, and he's trying to uphold power by a more democratic way, but he doesn't know how. And it's just the same as the opposition. It's not like the people know what they're doing. It's more like they're like children and they're just saying like, we don't want you to rule us, we can do what we want. It's sort of on the verge of anarchy a little bit, and they don't know what they're doing. They just don't want Elder. It's probably due to their lack of political knowledge, but it's still sort of annoying how stupid they are. Overall, I have to say A Million Suns is very repetitive and rather annoying. The story is still slow and the things that happen are rather predictable. I think the last book in this trilogy comes out in January 2013, so let's see how she finishes it. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the